Yeah, hello everybody, welcome to the show. I'm Sherry Schreiner. A couple things I want to talk about today, you know. Sitting here waiting for this snow apocalypse to hit. Nothing's happened. I think we have like 2 inches. It is cold, but it's December. So I expect cold. I expect snow. One of the most amusing things has been to watch the lizards on the Lizard Channel. The Weather Channel. On TV, because they're almost in glee and happiness when they think some kind of destruction is coming. But during hurricane season, they were beside themselves with happiness and glee that there was hurricanes. And now they're trying to trump up a snow apocalypse that just hasn't hit. Not here. Maybe other places. But, you know, it's December, so today is the first day of Hanukkah. And so happy Hanukkah. I know a lot of people, if you're following the internet stuff, you probably started it last night. And Hanukkah what are these holidays? It's not a feast commanded by the Lord that we follow, but it also talks about how Yahushua, when he was on the earth, went up to Israel during the dedication, or otherwise known as the Feast of Lights. So even back in his day, Hanukkah existed, and he went up to it, and so he wasn't ignoring it, he wasn't railing against it. It was one of these festivals adopted by the people, and so they observed it. And so Purim is another one that was adopted by the people, and I don't even follow that one. Hanukkah represents the Maccabees, who were fighting against the invasion of the Jewish temple, and they only had enough oil for one night, but their oil miraculously lasted for 8 days. And so this miraculous intervention by the Lord giving them oil to light their candles for 8 days is why we have Hanukkah. They celebrate that. And so, you know, there's a lot of people that would rather put up their pagan Christmas trees that Jeremiah says not to do, and call themselves Christians and say that they're celebrating the Lord's birthday when it has nothing to do with him or his birthday. It's actually a Roman God holiday, and he hates it. He hates it. You know, I have people that tell me all the time, oh, I'm celebrating it, and it's for his honor and his glory, and it's his birthday. And I have one thing to say. Have you ever asked him about it? Because when I asked him about it, he led me away from it. It's not one of those holidays that he says, oh, I don't care. Do what you want. You know, it really isn't. It's one of those holidays he will tell you, it's not about me. I'm not in it. And he hates it. And he will lead you away from it. Now, for some of you that has been ingrained in decorating Christmas trees and putting up wreaths, decorations your entire life, it's a culture shock. But it's one that slowly grabs hold of your heart year after year after year to where you just can no longer participate in it because you know he hates it. And so he will lead you away from it. And that's what he does. And he returns us to our Israelite roots that are in him. And you know what? He doesn't care how perfect we get it. It's the fact that we put some kind of effort into embracing and recognizing our Israelite roots that he enjoys. People don't realize that during the millennial reign, we will be under Torah law. And so all the Christians who are railing that the law is dead, you're going to be in for quite a shock. When during the millennial reign, 1,000 years, when Yahushua rules on earth, that we are celebrating his appointed times and feasts. His appointed times and feasts. Not your Christmas trees, not your Easter egg. His appointed times and feasts. Because they never stopped. They never ended. We never had an abruption so that for 2,000 years the church age could throw out all of his commandments, all his laws, all his feasts, and claim they're the most religious era ever to arrive. And that's how Christians view themselves and the churches of America. Oh, knowledge has increased, and we're the greatest generation. It's the biggest joke. We're the most apostate generation to ever call ourselves his people that's ever existed. But there's always a handful, and always there's always a minority that he keeps aside and to himself and away from the paganisms and apostasies. And through the centuries, his will and his people have always been carried on the backs of these minority who arise in every generation to stay faithful to him. And they're the ones who get beat up, and they're the ones rejected and hated by the majority. And that's the way it's always been, and it's no different today. Stand up against the churches today and try to tell them they're worshiping Sabbath on the wrong day. They spit fire. Tell them to throw their penis trees out, which is what they represent. They're phallic trees. They represent Nimrod's penis. And they decorate them with lights. And in Jeremiah 10, God spoke through Jeremiah and said, "Do not do as the pagans do." Cutting down trees and putting lights on them and decorating them. And it's exactly what churches do. They do the opposite of what he tells them to do. 6 days shalt thou labor and do all thy work, but on the seventh day keep it holy. We are commanded to keep the seventh day holy. The Sabbath day. The seventh day. And so you look at a calendar and you count. Sunday is the first day of the week. Monday is the second. Tuesday, the third. Wednesday is the fourth. Thursday is the fifth. Friday is the sixth. Oh, guess what? The seventh day is Saturday. Yeah. Big shock, huh, folks? And so the seventh day is the Sabbath day, the day we're commanded to keep holy. And yet the churches throw that one out and do what they want. And the Christians today do what they want and disregard what he says to do. See, we're living in a generation that claims they're his people, but they ignore everything he says and they do what they want to do. They do what's right in their own eyes, and yet they claim they're his. Another thing I like to go against is, when does the day begin? Because, like I said, if you even go on the internet today and look over the Jewish websites, they all tell you something different. Most of them, the majority, are wrong about everything as well as the Christian churches are. Because the Jews adopted the lunar calendar that was never given to them by the Father. They adopted a lunar calendar when they were imprisoned by the Babylonians. And they never went back to the solar calendar that the Father had given them. You know, you read in the creation, in Genesis chapter 1, in verse 3 and 4, the Lord said, "Let there be light," and there was light. And God saw the light, that it was good. And then in verse 4 continues, and he said, "And he divided the light from the darkness. And the light was called day, and the darkness he called night." He is the God of the day, of the light. So when does the day begin? The day begins at light, at sunrise. That is when the day begins. And then at night, the darkness. According to our calendar, the Gregorian calendar, our day is 24 hours. We include 12 hours of the day and 12 hours of the night. We have a 24-hour day. Day and night. He is the God of the day. The first 12 hours. The God of the night is another God. That's Satan's rule. He is the God of darkness. The God of the night. Day and night, folks. So when do you think the Father's Day begins? At sunrise. It does not begin at sunset. And the Jews today, as messed up as they are, all are, most of them, have still stuck to this lunar calendar where their day begins at night. Does that make any sense to you? If God is the God of day and light signifies day, then why would it start at night? It doesn't. It doesn't. Not in any calendar does the day start at night. But for some reason, the paganist Jews, have adopted this lunar calendar, and you can't tell them any differently about their lunar calendar than you can tell Christians how pagan Christmas is. They don't want to hear it. They don't want to hear. Christians don't want to hear about the Sabbath day being on the first day of the week being the wrong day. They don't want to hear about their pagan traditions. And neither do the Jews. Nobody wants truth. Everybody wants to do what's right in their own eyes. What's been the tradition. Or what's been a tradition for hundreds of years. So they keep it. Instead of just stopping what they're doing and turning around and starting to do something right. It's never too late to do something right. Just because you've been doing something wrong for thousands or hundreds of years doesn't mean it's right. We'll never be right. It will never be right. So what do? When you realize you've been doing something wrong, you stop. You just stop, and you start doing it the right way. The right way. If you can be faithful in a few things, he rewards you as ruler over many things later. You know, people want to know what we're judged on and rewarded on here on earth. How about just being faithful and doing the things that he says, you know? If you want to be great in his kingdom, and you want to be a ruler during the millennial reign on Christ, or reign of Christ on earth, these are the kinds of things that are going to be brought to notice. We all stand before the judgment seat of Christ. We all will one day. So what are you going to be rewarded for? If you couldn't listen and follow orders when you were alive on earth, you're not going to be deemed very reliable to be one that can listen and follow orders later down the road. Like I've said, and I've always said, there's very many levels and ranks in heaven. And I don't say this to beat up anybody. I'm saying this to help you. To help you, to lift you up, to get you out of the garbage you're in, and give you a reason why. Why is it important to follow the things he says? Why? Why should we? He doesn't care. He's not beating anybody over the head for lighting a Christmas tree or worshiping or honoring Sunday and the Sabbath instead of Saturday, and you go on and on. But the thing is, you lose rewards. Look at the things you're missing later. You weren't reliable on earth. You followed the pagan crowd on earth, calling yourselves his, but doing all the things he didn't want you to do. You did everything he said not to do. So what kind of a warrior in his army or singer in his choir or level or rank of his in heaven do you think you're going to have when you could not be faithful on earth to him? Oh, you might have loved him, but you were so adamant to stay in your paganisms and you couldn't be led into the truth. Nobody could tell you differently. You were stubborn and headstrong to go down the wrong ways. And nobody could turn you around. God couldn't turn you around himself. He couldn't speak through his prophets to turn you around. That labels you as completely unreliable, basically unfaithful, but for grace and mercy and reasons of mercy and grace, you'll be allowed to enter the kingdom of heaven because of your heart. But you were an unreliable servant. You were stubborn and headstrong and all the wrong things. And you did it out of love for him or just love for your own traditions. Because I realize people love him. That's why they put out mangers to begin with. But he hates it. And if you have a relationship with him, then you know he hates it. And isn't that what we're here for and what everything is about? Is building a relationship with him. With him? You don't have to go sit in a church pew and tithe to the pastor so he can buy a new lawnmower and go build a building in Africa that's never going to be built. Having a relationship with the Father starts with communication between you and him. It has nothing to do with the middleman. You know, I can't do that for people. People come to me all the time and want me to ask the Father this or that. I refuse. I just won't do it. Because our relationship starts with communication, and you have to start that with the Father. Communication. Talking to him, asking him to teach you how to hear him, listening to that small voice in your spirit. Most people think it's intuition. It's him speaking to their hearts. Him leading you in a direction or a way he wants you to go. These are all relationship building things. You gotta start somewhere, folks. It wasn't always easy for anyone, especially me. I started at the way bottom as everybody else. Asking them, teach me how to hear you. Let me know when it's you. I mean, understand when it's you and when it's not, because there's always voices speaking to your head. And those aren't him. And you learn that by the hard knocks. You learn he doesn't speak to your head. Those voices always lead you the wrong way. They lead you and it sounds good at first, but then they always mess up and lead you down the wrong way. you know, it's not Father. So what are you going to do, folks? You going to keep doing the wrong things? Or are you going to stop in your tracks with the little time we have left and turn it around and start doing the right things so that you can be accounted as a reliable and faithful servant of His on earth? Because only His reliables and faithfuls will ever rise above the level of being higher up in His kingdom. You're just going to be on the majority level, the majority bottom level. And yeah, there's a majority bottom level in heaven. And when you leave earth, that's where you're going to go in heaven, the majority bottom level. You weren't reliable on earth. You weren't a kingdom builder on earth. Kingdom builder producing fruits for Him. What's your fruits doing? What are you doing? Influencing others to ignore the Father? Ignore His ways? Is that what you want to be known for? Someone who led a church into ignoring the seventh-day Sabbath, into hanging up pagan penis trees and vagina wreaths on their doors and doing all the pagan things Jeremiah said not to? And someone who ignored Passover and adopted pagan fertility eggs instead? You promote paganism and you expect rank and level and reward in heaven? Come on, folks. And the worst thing is you influence others to do the same. Stop being an influence of others to do wrong. First you gotta turn yourself around, and then you gotta stop influencing others to do the wrong things and influence them to do the right things. It starts with a small bowl, and it's top of a hill, top of a mountain, and you throw it down the mountain, and it gets bigger and bigger and bigger as it goes down the mountain. That's how truths always are. They start small, and then as more people embrace the truths, they'll get bigger and bigger and bigger. Problem is, we're never at that level where we're even halfway down the mountain. People still embracing paganism. And instead of in adopting truths and going to the Lord, they shun you. They hate you. That's how it is. Do you think I'm well accepted? I'm well received on the internet for any of the truths I've been giving for 17 years? No, people hate you. They hate you. They shun you. They push you away. And that's how it is. You're always going to be hated. But I'm not here to make man happy, to please man. I'm here to please God. I'm here to please God. And when they come against me, they're just coming against Him because I speak for Him. He stood me up to speak to the nations. To the nations. You know what that means? It means all nations can be saved through Him. Whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. It does not matter if you're yellow, green, orange, purple, white, black, brown. Whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. And you know what? Then get it right. Do the things He says to do. Honor His ways. Adopt His practices. We're to become like Him. He's not going to become like us. We're to become like Him. We're here for Him. People got it backwards. They get so arrogant and they think God is here for them. And all they do night by night, day by day, is give them these long I want lists. I need this. I want that. The only time they pray is when they want something. We're here for Him, folks. What can I do for you today, Father? Lead me in the ways you want me to go. Light and direct my path. We're here for Him. So it's never too late. Never too late to realize, man, I have been led down the wrong road. 30-some years, I knew there was something wrong with that. I knew there was something up because your heart never feels right when it's in the wrong. And you just stop it. You open the door and you throw the tree out. You take the lights out, you put them in a box, and you throw them out. And you throw your Easter egg crap out. And you start embracing the ways of the Father. And be careful about where you run on the internet, because the Jewish sites will even lead you astray. Basic principles, folks. Learn. And when you learn the basic principles, everything else will fall in line. We're not perfect, but we give it effort, and He knows our effort. He sees our efforts, folks. Anyway, my time for the show is out. I am done ranting for the day. Hopefully you see this as a truth that you can embrace. Anyway, folks, be back on Friday at noon. Till then, God bless.